Hello, welcome at Tech Talk episode 7. As you might know by now, Hero will try to answer as many questions you have on our products or system related questions. If you have any questions left after looking at this clip, leave them below at the comments bar. So the first question that I have is from Matt Newman, and he is asking, I would love to see a discussion of the VE.Bus BMS versus a Lynx Smart BMS. Why and when you should use one over the other when using VE batteries. Well, the major difference between these BMSs is that the Lynx Smart BMS has a contactor, which means if something goes wrong with the batteries, an overvoltage or an undervoltage, the system will isolate itself from the batteries. If you have a VE.Bus BMS, the same functionality is there, but you have to connect something externally to it, a contactor or a battery protect, in order to isolate the batteries from the system. Normally, when the system gets larger, so with a larger current also, then you use the Lynx system. So the distributor for fusing all the batteries, and then the Lynx Smart BMS as a BMS to control your charger inverter, but also your DC loads, and of course your protection of the batteries. The next question is from Ruuvi van Doornegat, and he is asking, why do some fuses rated at 100 amp, for example, blow at 100 amps, while others will blow far above this value? What are the factors considering to select a fuse for your DC system? Well, Ruuvi, a fuse is made for a certain application, and it doesn't mean that a fuse which doesn't blow at exactly 100 amps isn't a good fuse. It is just designed to be used for another application. For inverters or other loads which have an overload capacity, you will need a slow blow fuse. That means you can handle some overload, but you're protected against short circuit. Next question is about the battery protect. And the question is, I'm very confused about the low voltage disconnect. In previous videos, I saw that the low voltage disconnect is set to disconnect at a voltage of about 11.8 volt, where I have read that the 12 volt battery is at 50% discharge on 12.2. So why is the battery protect set at 11.8? Well, the reason for this is because the battery voltage is not a constant value. That means if you discharge a battery very fast, that the voltage will drop also. But if you stop discharging, the voltage will recover itself again. That means if you stop discharging at, let's say, 11.8 volts, the battery could very well recover to 12.2 or 12.3. If you would switch off at exactly the point of the state of charge corresponding with that voltage, you could hardly discharge that battery at a certain level because all the time the battery protect will stop discharging it. So this means if you have a high load on your battery, you will have to have the battery protect set at the reasonably low level of discharge. If you have a very slow discharging current, you should have the battery voltage at a higher voltage, because otherwise your battery will drain much further than what you have actually planned to do. The next question is coming from Broxine. And Broxine is asking, can you tell me the difference between hub 1, 2, 3, and 4 and ESS? Well, basically a hub is a software setting so that you can make a self-consumption system out of your installation. We used to have a different version for DC coupled or AC coupled or a combination of those two. And after a while, these are being compiled into one, and that became the ESS setting. So with ESS, you can do DC coupled system, AC coupled system, but also a combination of those two. So basically for all self-consumption systems, ESS is the setting to use. The next question is about the smart battery sense. What is the difference between the smart battery sense and the smart shunt? Well, I happen to have them here both. First of all, the smart battery sense. The smart battery sense is a device that you can measure the voltage and also the temperature of your battery. And that information can be forwarded to your MPPT or other device in your system so that it can be used to optimize your charging. A smart shunt is a device which measures current. So it measures the current which flows to your batteries and also towards your DC load. And with that information, it can calculate what the state of charge of your battery is. Well, maybe you already noticed, but this is the new model, which is the follow-up of the current models that we have. This one is water resistance. So stay tuned, because there will be a 500, this is a 1000, and a 2000 amp version. So that was the last question from this tech talk. I also have some new stuff. And the new stuff is these sensors. I think for a lot of people who are already on VRM, it's very nice to see how your system is doing, your voltage and your amps and your solar yield and so on. But now you can also see what the humidity, or the temperature, and also the air pressure is in your system. The only thing you have to do is digitally connect this one to your servo with Bluetooth, and then you see all the information also on the VRM website. This will work from version 2.8 or higher, so you have to update your servo for that. and these ones can be ordered online. There are two versions. There's the Pro version and there is also the normal version. Basically, they do the same. Thank you for watching Tech Talk. If you have any questions left, leave them at the comments below.